Yellow diamond or blue diamond? Whose side are you on? Snag a tee or hoodie from our store. Link in the description. Welcome back to Crystal Clear on the Roundtable. I'm AwestruckVox. If you celebrated Thanksgiving, I hope you had a great one. If you're Black Friday shopping, I wish you the best of luck. And today, I wanted to deliver some news on Mystery Girl. You know the unidentified woman Pearl is so head over heels for, who kinda looks like Rose. Ooh, Pearl. Now, Mystery Girl has become an absolute fan favorite. She definitely has a following within the fandom of Steven Universe. And many fans have been dying for her to come back. Seriously, people will grab at anything to point, hey, I think this will be her return. Even for a while, we thought the show was an upcoming episode, but apparently that was concept art for Last One Out of Beach City. And Mystery Girl's different design kinda gives it away. But hey, I was very hopeful and really wanted a roller skating episode. Woe is me. But in this week's Steve Universe podcast, hosted by Mackenzie Atwood, we learned Mystery Girl actually may not be coming back. Roll the clip.
So you mentioned Mystery Girl. I'm kind of wondering how Mystery Girl came about in development and everything.
Well, I mean, I know that the idea with her was to make someone that kind of looked like Rose, that mm-hmm. she had a type, and it would be this.
Yeah. Yeah, it was kind of a joke, and the fact that she looks exactly, or not exactly, but so similar to Rose, just like, oh, she really has a type. But the character, I think, was there to kind of just serve this idea that, like, we didn't want to specifically say, like, they're going to have a relationship beyond this, but it was just kind of this episode to prove that Pearl has, like, changed and moved on in a way from all of the baggage in her past and stuff, and she's willing to do and try new things. So, I know that she came about because we were like, what is one of the biggest ways we can show that she's a more independent character now? And, yeah, having her get interested in another pink-haired woman.
Whoa, yikes. I have several questions. Now, I know the prospect of Mystery Girl not coming back is pretty devastating to a lot of fans. And for other people, they're probably like, woohoo! No more Bargain Bin Rose! But as someone who wants to see more of this character, let me argue why Mystery Girl could come back and why she may have even got her own storyline. One, Rebecca Schicker has stated over and over again, there are no one-off characters in Steven Universe, which means every character would appear at least twice. Now, not counting all the Homeworld and Crystal Gems, as they obviously will come back again, this is true for all the human characters. Most of them have made comebacks. The only exception right now is, of course, Mystery Girl, Onion's friends, and Mr. Frowny. But considering I believe this show's gonna go on for a lot longer, video on that coming soon, I think we'll have more than enough time to revisit all these characters. Second, even if she was intended for a one-off appearance, you know, something to just show Pearl has moved on, the Crooniverse is now blind to the fact that Mystery Girl is extremely popular. Seriously, when I went to New York Comic Con the first time, which was about a month after Last One Out of Beach City first aired, I saw so many Mystery Girl cosplayers. Legitimately, she was the most cosplayed Steven Universe character I've ever seen at a con. A lot of people are clearly intrigued by this character. And when it comes to shows, especially animated series, fandom man goes a long way. Unless it has something to do with ships. Third and finally, the story for a series, especially a long-running series, changes all the time. Usually only the ending's in mind, and even an ending can change. Tidbits like a minor character's role can definitely change. Hell, Amethyst wasn't intended to be an overcooked run. Amethyst's character arc was modified by Rebecca Sugar to reflect Michaela Deeds, Amethyst's voice actress. By the way, we did a podcast with her. If you've never seen that before, I'll link that at the end of the video. Just because a character was created in the moment to be intended for one thing, doesn't mean they won't be revisited later and expanded upon to play a bigger role in the story. Plus, I don't like the idea of showing that Pearl can move on without actually following through with it. I would like to see an arc with her and Mystery Girl where Mystery Girl changes her hair color, starts to look less and less like Rose, and Pearl is still into her, and learns how to be in a different kind of relationship. I think that'd be really healthy for her. And I'm not letting go of the Sabina name drop. In fact, a few people on Twitter have DM'd me something very interesting that I'll touch on in a video really soon. But as always, what are your thoughts? Do you hope Mystery Girl makes a return? And if so, what do you want her role to be? You can comment your thoughts below or tweet them to me at AwestruckVox. You can also follow the Roundtable on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, all at RoundtableVids, and on Snapchat at RoundtableYT. Get a glimpse of our shenanigans and stay updated on our videos. We also have a Discord, official Amino app, and Patreon. And hey, swing by our Teespring store. Grab a yellow or blue diamond teen hoodie. Links to everything in the description. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like, share it with your friends, and if you're new here, hit that subscribe button. It really helps us out. Hit that bell for notifications so you never miss a video from the Roundtable. I hope you have a beautiful day. And AwestruckVox, signing out.